What's up, guys? Welcome back for a weekend in my life vlog. Not much is going to be going on today. I do need to go to Trader Joe's later, and I'm actually about to place an order for Starbucks. I have figured out the best fall drink. I'm going to go ahead and post it here on the screen. It's an iced shaken espresso with almond milk, pumpkin cream cold foam, no classic syrup, and then 2 pumps of pumpkin sauce. I'm telling you guys, it is so dang good. It is definitely not good for the bank account, but I'm telling you, it is so good for the soul. Tomorrow we do have an estate sale that we're going to, which I'm very excited for. I'll try and vlog as much of that as I can. And then I did want to go ahead and show you guys some things that we got in yesterday. I'm so excited. We got really good bags and also a couple pairs of Chanel espadrilles. Also, peep my new Ghani shirt. I think I showed this in my last vlog. I'm so obsessed. I think it's so, so cute. But I want to show you guys the new stuff we got in because I think you'll be really excited. So I didn't feel like taking everything out because it would have just taken too much time, but I did want to show you some of my favorite things we got in. One being this gorgeous Chanel pink bag. It has stunning gold hardware, and I'm obsessed with like the straw like material. This would have been so nice to have in the spring and summertime, but I'm still so happy we got it in. And then we also got in this really nice Louis Vuitton agenda. It's in great condition. We also got in 2 of these quilted Chanel wallets that are also in pretty good condition. There are some signs of wear. Everything, of course, will be pictured. This bag I'm in love with as well. It's also another really good like summery bag, but I feel like you can also kind of transition it into the fall time because of the brown. It has this really pretty like silk scarf just like woven throughout. It's actually new with tags, you guys, as well, which is insane. I mean, who would buy this stunning bag and never wear it? I don't even know. And then, like I said, we did get in 2 pairs of Chanel espadrilles. The first pair is this black leather, and then the other is like a blue denim material. They're both really cute. I believe they're both a size 9, but I would just check the website to be sure because I honestly don't really remember. But we got in some really great items. Really excited about this. Like I said, there is more coming, but I just didn't feel like taking it all out, and I just had to show you guys my faves. Got the goods. Yum. You excited? I think I'm gonna go in Diptyque. I've honestly never been here before. My friend Lexi said it's really good. They mostly have like candles and perfumes, I think. First time in the Williamsburg Aloe, and I had no idea that they have a bar upstairs, which is so cool. Spencer's looking the men's. He's never been in an Aloe store either, so he's like really enjoying himself. Because I'm obsessed with these Aloe yoga pants that have these like wide flare with the slit. They're so, so cute. But I love the white, and I just know I would get them dirty. Also, I don't think I showed, but they're the Airbrush High Waist Flutter leggings. If you guys are interested, I'll have them linked in the description box too. So we are back in the car from our little trip around Williamsburg. I don't know if I got too many clips in the store, but Madewell was actually having this really cool pop-up with ThredUp, and they were selling secondhand stuff, which I thought was really cool. Their prices were a little high, and I'm also not the biggest fan of Madewell in general, but I just thought the concept was really cool. I feel like more brands should consider doing that because I feel like it's a good way to bring in extra money and also promote sustainability. And you guys know, as a reseller, obviously I'm just gonna think that's cool. But now I think we're gonna head to Trader Joe's. We have a grocery list of things we need to pick up. We need like almond milk, coffee creamer. I don't know, is there anything else you can think of?
I don't know, just frozen stuff maybe.
Yeah, we're a big fan of frozen stuff because it's just the two of us. Doesn't really make sense to make a whole feast for 2 people because all of the leftovers just end up going bad, and we're also just like bad at eating leftovers in general. So we're a big fan of like Trader Joe's pre-cooked like frozen meals. They're really good. And then I also love their Takis. Oh my god, they're so good.
Thank you.
back at the apartment, I figured I'd go ahead and do a little Trader Joe's haul, show you guys everything I got. I know I love watching Trader Joe's hauls. I feel like they always have so many fun things. And obviously right now they have all of their fall stuff, so I got a lot of pumpkin flavored things. So the first thing I got is this pumpkin spice teeny tiny pretzels, basically just like these coated pretzels. They look super good. I've never had them before. And then these are the Takis I was telling you guys about. They're like the chili and lime chips. Oh my God, 10 out of 10. You guys seriously need to try them if you haven't already because they're life changing. I got hamburger buns because we're having burgers tonight. I think we're gonna go grill up on our rooftop, which will be really fun. And then I picked these up the last time I was at Trader Joe's and they are pretty good. They're the roasted seasoned Brussels sprouts with Parmesan cheese. They were really good as well. And they're just like an easy side to kind of have with any meal. And then I'm also trying this for the first time. I've never had it. It just looked good. It's their cedar wrapped barbecue sockeye salmon filet. So I'm excited to try this. I've never made salmon before, so wish me luck. And then I also picked up two of these, one for us and then one for my mom. It's their dark chocolate peanut butter cups. We always like to have these on deck. It's just a nice like treat after dinner. We also keep those in the freezer. I feel like they taste better frozen. And then I also picked this up for my mom because she doesn't have a Trader Joe's near her. It's the pumpkin spice coffee. I also haven't tried it yet, so I'm kind of excited to try it whenever I go visit her. And then we got shishito peppers. If you guys watched some of my other vlogs, I talked about our obsession. And then obviously I got milk. The only thing I didn't get was creamer because the creamer they had sunflower oil in it. And I'm pretty sure that's the one oil that Flav City says to like stay away from and it's no good. So I'm just gonna like run to Whole Foods, I guess, and grab one there. My favorite is the Chobani, but Whole Foods doesn't have that either. And then I also got the roasted corn, which is really good. I love this with their elote seasoning on it. I got two of these Suja organic lemon ginger cayenne juices. These are like my favorite juices to get. They have them at Whole Foods too. And then I'm so excited. I have been on the hunt for these. They're the Lacombe pumpkin spice latte. So I'm so excited. I grabbed two of these. I'm hoping I like them because I got two. If not, I'm sure Spencer will. And then I also picked these up for Spencer because he loves these. They're the brownie crisp coffee ice cream sandwiches. They are pretty good if you guys are into like darker coffee. It's not super sweet or anything. And then I figured for a fun, like calm, maybe like one Sunday morning, it would be fun to have these, even though they're so not healthy. I got the pumpkin rolls because they just look so good. And I'm such a fan of a cinnamon roll, but we just don't buy them that often because obviously it's not the healthiest thing. And then I just got some organic free range chicken, but that's all for the haul. I'm gonna go ahead and put this away. Spencer's still trying to park. Parking in Brooklyn is so bad right now. I feel like it's gotten so busy the past couple of weeks. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that away, but I think I'm gonna go ahead and dig into these coffees because they're so good. So it's now a little after 6. I think we're gonna head up to the roof and grill. I do need to go ahead and grab everything. And I'm also gonna cut up an onion for the burgers. The burgers we bought are just these Bubba's burgers. I think they're like an onion, yeah, sweet onion pie. Guys, if this isn't a vibe, I don't know what is. I mean, the view tonight is stunning. Good morning, guys. Happy Sunday. We just got back from a morning walk. Lucy is like so happy, as you can tell. Today we're gonna be going to an estate sale, which I'm really excited for. I did just crack open one of these THECLOSETNY pumpkin lattes because I was out of creamer and I was also really excited to try these. I've been looking everywhere for it. So, honestly, really good. I feel like it's a perfect mixture between strong coffee and sweet. I don't like anything too sweet, but I also hate dark coffee. So this is like perfect. So I definitely recommend getting this. I grabbed it at Trader Joe's. I've looked everywhere and haven't been able to find it. So if you're looking for it, definitely recommend going to Trader Joe's. But I'm just gonna hang out for a minute, drink this, and then I need to get in the shower and get ready because... So I just finished getting ready. I figured I'd go ahead and do a little OOTD. Also, I tried doing something different with my hair. I usually don't wear it like this. I used to. I basically just like pulled it up in a ponytail. It's like second day hair with dry shampoo. And then I just curled the back of it. It's like a super simple 5-minute hairstyle. I'm wearing my chocolate brown All Saints hoodie. If I can find it, I'll have it linked down below. I picked this up last fall. I absolutely love it. It's such good quality. And then I'm wearing these like joggers that are seriously the most comfortable thing ever. They're by the brand Thacoon, and I actually got them at Goodwill the other day. And they're like such good quality. They retail for like $100, so it was such a steal. Really happy I found those. I'm just gonna wear my Air Force Ones that I wear every day, but I also wanted to show you guys my new favorite lipstick at the moment. It's from Charlotte Tilbury. I'm like obsessed with everything she has in her collection. I wanna buy more makeup from her, but this is the lipstick Pillow Talk. I've had this before and I lost it, so I actually went and bought another one because I love it so much. I feel like it's good on every skin tone. It's like a matte lipstick, but it doesn't dry your lips too much. And she also has like the prettiest packaging. All of her stuff is like rose gold. I'm obsessed. But we're about to head out the door, go to this estate sale. Hopefully we get some good stuff. Like I said, they have Hermes scarves, so really hoping we can get our hands on those, and hopefully they're still left because we're not going right when they open. We just didn't really want to like rush this morning because we had some other things we needed to do, but let's go. Hits the curb every single time. He just hit it again. It's every time, you guys.
It's like I don't live in the city.
Yeah, he literally runs over the sidewalk, but it's fine. So we just got to the estate sale. We're about to go in. I just wanted to update you guys, and then after we're gonna meet Spencer's dad and go get lunch, but I guess I'll catch up with you guys after. Wish us luck. Back from the estate sale, figured we'd go ahead and show you guys what we got. It wasn't the best estate sale ever. Unfortunately, the Hermes scarf had already sold, which I'm not surprised considering it's already so late. But one of the things we did get a bag. It's the brand Hogan. This is our first Hogan bag. It's in really good condition. Nice light brown leather bag, good for fall. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that back there.
I think we've sold the sneakers before, which like what they're, I think that's what they're known for.
Yeah, I think so too. You wanna go ahead and show the shoes? Sure. We also got some clothes. I'll show you after he shows the shoes.
So we got some APL sneakers, which usually sell well.
Yeah, they're really nice too. I feel like, honestly, I wonder if they're my size. They're a nice sneaker, but I did also just order a new pair of Nikes, so don't really need them right now.
These UGG clogs.
Good for the upcoming season. Nice like Sherpa trim.
And clogs are pretty popular right now.
Yeah.
And then these kind of plain but still Prada heels.
Yeah. Just simple. Yep, little slingbacks. And then for clothing, we got 3 pairs of Lululemon leggings. This one is like a patterned. They are cropped, which I usually don't pick up unless they're really cheap. This is like a navy cropped. And then this pair is actually really nice. They're like feel like they're almost brand new. I've only been worn a couple times. I believe they're all sizes like 8. This pair is just like a dusty blue, really nice though. And then we did get 3 J. Crew sweaters, which I normally don't pick up to be honest, but these had some cashmere in them and the price was right, and they're like a nice pretty cable knit. This one has a turtleneck, and then the next 2 are pretty much the same. They're like a navy V-neck cable knit. So they're nice staples for the fall and winter time. So we went ahead and grabbed those, but now we're gonna head to Spencer's dad's and go to lunch with him. So we will catch up with you guys after. Bye. So we just sat down for lunch at the Ritz. We're with Spencer's dad and Izzy. And obviously Spencer. It's such a beautiful day here. It's a really cute town. If you guys live in Long Island, I definitely recommend coming by. There's a lot of cute shops. We'll probably get some ice cream or custard after.
Yep. Very dog friendly.
Very dog friendly. So many cute puppies. We just got our food. I got a shrimp basket. Spencer got an omelet of some sort. What did you get?
A Caesar salad and ahi tuna.
That looks really, really good. just said bye to Spencer's dad. We had so much fun. Now we are actually about to go into a Savers that we haven't been to in probably over a year. So I'm kind of excited to just pop in quickly to see what they have. And then after here, I think we're gonna go to HomeSense because I just wanna stop by and see if they have anything new. And I haven't been there in probably a year also. So excited to check it out, but I'll try and vlog in here as much as I can. I probably won't get too many clips. We are back home now. We ended up not going to HomeSense because we didn't want to leave Lucy alone too long, but I figured I'd go ahead and show you guys everything I got. I did go ahead and get a candle while we were in Northport from, I think it's called Nest on Main. Lucy can smell it apparently. It smells really good. Kind of has like a pumpkin fall scent, and the packaging is so cute. That's honestly what sold me. Lucy, come on. It says fall in New York. I just thought it would be adorable, and as soon as I smelled it, oh my gosh, I wish you guys could smell it. It smells so good. As soon as I smelled it, I knew I had to have it. And then I figured I'd go ahead and show you everything we got at Savers. We ended up finding a lot more than we were expecting to. One of the first things I found was a cashmere theory sweater, and Spencer said it reminds him of what the guy from Blue's Clues wears, and he's so right. This literally looks like the same sweater, just like green striped, but it's 100% cashmere. We love picking up cashmere sweaters for the fall time. And then it's also my first time picking up this brand. It's a brand Marine Layer. Never picked it up before. It kind of seemed like comps were all over the place. Some of them were really good, others were not. And sometimes that's just people letting their own stuff go too little. And it also had a little bit of cashmere in it. It's like a really pretty tan color. Perfect for the fall time. You guys know I'm all about neutral colors. And it also seemed like somebody donated their whole old Lululemon collection because they had so many leggings. And like I said earlier, I normally don't pick up cropped, but because they've just been at such a good price, I went ahead and grabbed them. They had this plain gray pair. Here's what they look like, very simple. Lululemon always sells well, so if it's at a good enough price, I definitely pick it up. Other than like tank tops, I feel like those are the only thing that don't really move. These are just like a cropped camo legging. They say Soul Cycle on the side. And then this next pair has like a blue waistband. They're gray. Once again, they are cropped. And then I did get one full length pair. These are really good quality. They kind of remind me of the pair that I got from the estate sale. This is what they look like, but they do have a zipper at the cuff, which is a nice little added detail. And this next thing I picked up was also kind of a rare buy for me because I normally don't pick up Anthropologie, but because they were a flare legging, I thought I'd go ahead and give them a try. Plus, I might honestly try them on for myself because I really love those flutter leggings from Aloe yesterday, but they were like over $100 and I just didn't feel like spending that at the moment. But here's what they look like, just a plain black yoga pant. The flare leggings are coming back, you guys, so don't hate on the flare leggings. And then I also found this pair of helmet wing dress pants. These are really cool. They have like a contrast waistband, zipper at the cuff, super cute. And then Spencer also found a couple of things. I'll go ahead and show you guys. This is also for the business. He found this Etro gingham men's dress shirt. And then he also found a Loro Piana blazer, which is really, really nice. It's another good color for fall. It's like a tan blazer, which is really nice. So now I think I'm gonna go place an order, pick up some ramen, but we do need to go walk Lucy, so I will catch up with you guys once we get back. It looks delish. I always get the spicy tofu ramen with no tofu. They added corn to this one. I don't know why they did that. We'll see if it's good. I love the like kale in it though. It's so, so delish. So I've got the Yule log going on the TV. I'm about to sit down and edit my vlog that would have went live before the one you're currently watching. So if you haven't watched that, make sure you go do so. Also, I wanted to show you guys that I am keeping this light up pumpkin. I actually think it looks really cute in the apartment, and that with my string lights, it just is all the cozy vibes right now. I do need to go light a candle, but I think I'm gonna go ahead and end off this vlog. I do wanna ask you guys though to go ahead and comment down below and let me know if you guys enjoy my daily vlogs more, or if you really enjoyed this one, like a weekend in my life over multiple days. Maybe I could also do like a week in my life. I don't know. I feel like the weekend was just a good place to start. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye. She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her.